Sorry, we need to breathe just for a second. How about this band? David Hawkins, man. He was really kind enough to let me kind of play drums. Because I'll tell you what, I hate congas. They make my fingers really big. I worked, on occasion, most of it's play though. I've been very, very blessed. This is my 50th year of playing drums. This gentleman I met in 1978, and he was just the cutest kid. He was 3 years younger than I was, and I think maybe of all the records I've ever done, his probably are of the top 10 or of the top 5 of what I've done, and I can maybe throw Steve Winwood in there and stuff, but I'm referring to Michael Jackson. And I did a bunch of stuff with him. Like I said, I came in and overdubbed, and you know, and Quincy didn't really like songs called B-sides. So I ended up doing those two, and then coming back and doing Don't Stop, and that was great. And then Quincy was just the king. I mean, he was my mentor. And I've learned all my production techniques and all sorts of just life skills from this great gentleman who still can outhang me at any given night. You know, I tried to hang with him till 5 a.m. and I just like lay on the floor. And he's still up till 6, 7 a.m. and stuff. But he would cast, like a Spielberg would cast a film. And he would cast his rhythm sections. And I was absolutely fortunate enough to be the constant just the constant on the entire Off the Wall album, which to me, still to this day, is the best Michael Jackson album ever. And, you know, Thriller obviously sold more, but Off the Wall was all analog. It was the convergence of all these great people, like Jerry Hay and Rod Temperton and Louis Johnson and Hawk Walensky and Greg Fillinganes and David Williams, it just kept going on. Michael Boddicker from Iowa. And myself. And so he's casting different rhythm sections. You know, there was one time where I'm seeing, there's four guitar players, three of them are laying, sleeping on the couch. I don't know, you know, one was Wawa Watson, speaking of that last one. You know, I didn't remember playing with Wawa once, but he was there. So this next tune, you guys tell me what song this is.
How conditioned is Mitch?
So I have a ringtone.
You can't not do that if you're sitting at a keyboard.
I have a ringtone that goes like this. Hello? It's funny, I'm known for 4 fucking beats. Sorry, Judy. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, Allison Nash back. So this was cast, again, in Quincy Jones' casting. This was my band, Rufus, who cut this song. A lot of people don't know that. It was Bobby Watson on bass, Hawk Walensky on keyboards, and David Williams on guitar. And we were 3 takes in. And at Westlake B, and it wasn't happening. It was not happening. There was no magic. We weren't getting the take. Everybody was like, do-do-do-do-do-do-do. All of a sudden, I look in and I see Quincy and Rod Temperton come out, and Quincy stands right here, and Rod stands right here, smoking his red Marlboros and puffing them at me. And I'm going, Quincy looks at me, he goes, Jana, can you come up with an intro fill that the whole world will forever identify with? And I'm going, yeah, sure. And meanwhile, my nose has gotten out like this from colloquialism. And Hawk and everybody, they're looking at me like, oh boy, I wouldn't want to be in your shoes. So that was take three. So take four came out, and the rest is history.
Here we go.
Rock with you.